Good afternoon, HF, and welcome to the Friday episode of the VTV Show. I'm Summer Owens. We have all kinds of segments for your enjoyment today, all produced by Production 2 Class. Today, we'll start with yet another look at our staff and who these people are that put together the show.
As you all know by now, VTV has a new staff. Last week, we met 5 members, so today we'll meet 5 more. Gabe, Amelia, Cameron, Harrell, and Joelle. Starting with Gabe. One thing about him is that he is our only senior, even if he doesn't act like it.
I don't think anyone knows this, but I have a teddy bear collection.
Amelia.
I'm good at making cat noises.
The only person I know who's bold enough to do her makeup in front of a teacher and on camera. Cameron. According to him, he likes the simple things. But when it comes to things he doesn't like...
One thing I don't like is people who don't do their work and annoy me.
This is Harrell. He talks a lot. And this is Joelle, who doesn't. They fight a lot, but Harrell thinks it's reasonable.
Because this guy doesn't know what he's doing. Look at him.
That's all for today's edition of Meet the Staff. Make sure to come back next time to meet the final members of production.
What's up, HF? I'm Joelle Sterling. February is Black History Month, and today we look at someone in history you may have never heard of. This person has made a huge impact on our society, and it's highlighted today on VTV.
Hello, Vikings. Since it's Black History Month, I decided it's only right to come on here and recognize our Black History figures. I'm going to do that a little bit differently. You see, every year we celebrate the same historic figures, so I thought, why don't I tell you about a Black History hero you may have never heard of? Most people have heard of Rosa Parks, but did you know she wasn't the first Black person to refuse to give up their bus seat? On March 2nd, 1955, Claudette Colvin, born Claudette Austin, was arrested at the young age of 15 years old in Montgomery, Alabama, for refusing to give up her bus seat to a white woman on a segregated bus. This was 9 months before the more known Rosa Parks incident. Colvin helped spark the Montgomery bus boycott and played a huge role in the Browder v. Gale case that ended bus segregation in Alabama. So why isn't she as famous as Rosa Parks? Leaders in the civil rights movement didn't think she was the most appealing representative for the movement due to her being a pregnant teen and not having good hair or fair skin. It's important to acknowledge the lesser-known civil rights activists because they play a crucial role in the civil rights movement. I'm Joelle Sterling from VTV, and this is the Black History Month Spotlight.
I'm Ian Duckett, and today we continue with Black History Month as we take to the halls of HF to see what this month means to our students and staff.
Black history actually means a lot to me. It's very important for many reasons, but one main reason being just to remind people about all the events and everything that Black people went through and what we had to go through and our struggle we had to go through for equality.
The importance of Black History Month is to show recognition to Black people and everything they've achieved.
Being with family and people that are your culture and bringing diversity into the world.
It's like to celebrate my people and what we've been through for all these years.
Black history is extremely important. In our country, we have a lot of people of color, so they should know their history. Those of us that are not necessarily of color should know their history. It all contributes to our country's history. It is important to me specifically just because, I mean, everybody should want to know, and this should be important to everybody.
Very important to celebrate Black History Month and learn what others have gone through so that you can see how other people feel and how they felt.
The importance of Black History is to celebrate everything Black people have done for, I don't know, America.
Black History Month means to me like the importance about where we came from, learning about our culture, learning about our family and our heritage.
Importance of Black history is it's really important for everybody to have an understanding of their roots and where they come from, and to know the stories that have been passed down For numerous reasons, it gives us a sense of ownership, and we like to all know, you know, our ancestry and what our ancestors went through. And then also in terms of history, we want to make certain that we don't repeat the past. Part of the reason we study history is so we learn from it and we can move on and make better decisions in the future as a collective whole.
Hey sports fans, Gabe Gatherite here, and you all know what this weekend means in the world of sports. It's Super Bowl weekend, the biggest day in sports, and we'll see the Kansas City Chiefs go up against the Philadelphia Eagles. Who will take the title? Let's see what the HF body thinks.
Season, 32 teams, two good quarterbacks came out of it, and two teams came out. So now we got to see who people got, Kansas City or the Eagles. Let's go. Who you got, KC or the Eagles?
The Eagles all the way, you know what I'm saying? They tough.
I'll take the Eagles. They've been the best team from start to finish, and I think they're going to finish the job.
Who do you got, KC or the Eagles?
The Eagles.
Kansas City.
All right.
KC, of course.
So who you got, bro? Chiefs or the Eagles?
I got 100 on the Eagles.
All right.
Taking Kansas City.
All right. Who you got?
I got the Eagles.
Who you got, KC or the Eagles?
I got Philly.
Who do you got?
I'm going with the Eagles. I'm going with KC. Gotta go with the Magic Man.
Eagles or KC?
Eagles.
So who you got? Chiefs or Eagles?
I got the Eagles.
KC or the Eagles?
I got the Eagles.
So who do you got? Kansas City or the Eagles?
Eagles. I'm going to say Kansas City. I don't know why, but they just sound like a good team.
So it all boils down who's going to win Sunday, Chiefs or the Eagles? A lot of people pick the Eagles. Some people pick the Chiefs. They play Sunday at 5:30 p.m. I'll be watching, and I hope you're watching too. This is Gabe Gatherite from VTV. Have a good one.
I'm Cameron Williams.
And I'm Amelia Bruni. We're very competitive here at VTV.
So much so that Amelia and I decided to go head-to-head in a Valentine's baking contest.
Cameron in the kitchen? I can't wait to see this.
Check out our contest and you be the judge.
Hey guys, so Valentine's Day is right around the corner, and what screams Valentine's Day like special desserts?
So today Cam and I will be making Valentine's Day themed desserts and competing against who can make the best, and Ewan will be our judge.
So Cameron and Amelia have me here today to judge their baking skills, and I definitely think this is going to be an interesting competition.
Okay, so right here, this is my side of all the ingredients that I'm using.
All right, so here's what I'll be baking with today, an assortment of items.
So it's like I'm making Oreo balls, so I just need Oreos and I need to crush them up. My cream cheese right here, I just cut some of it. I'm just putting it in with the butter, and then I'm gonna mix it. Mixing the cream cheese and butter in with the Oreos. So after you're done mixing them together, you just get your hand and just like roll them into balls. So far I'm feeling pretty well. I think I'm gonna win. Okay, so I have all the balls rolled out, and so now I'm gonna put it in the fridge for like around 40 minutes and they're gonna cool.
First off, to start my brownies, gotta start with flour. Learn this trick from. Oh.
No.
Nice and level. Now I pour my nicely put flour into the bowl. All done. Now we get three eggs to crack. Professional egg cracker. These aren't just any brownies, these are Nutella brownies. You need a full thing of Nutella. Sitting here for 3 hours stirring this, so I got this thing. Honestly, it's a something. I find no point in this, I find no value in this, but I was told to do so. Nice and evenly, that Nutella coming out very slow, but it's looking very good. Bacon's going pretty well right now. I got a lot of things going my way. Once you're ready, you have your oven at 350 and put it in for about 20 minutes.
And we're gonna dip it in and then just like cover these truffles all up. Okay, so I'm done with these Oreo truffle balls. I did light pink, hot pink, and then red sprinkles.
Just got out of the oven, smells good. Looks even better. Here's the secret weapon. Strawberry frosting. Now, I may or may not have thought it was pink frosting when I bought it. It's strawberry, so I'm gonna make it work. Looks, the taste, I can just tell Ewan is going to love it.
First, we're gonna start off with Cameron's, so let's try this. It's pretty good. It's actually pretty good. So for Amelia, we're gonna try the pink one and let's see how this tastes. That's pretty good. Both are pretty good. I think this one's definitely tastes a lot better though.
So today we were able to have a little Valentine's Day fun showcasing our baking skills. I came up a little short, but hey, nothing more I could have done. From VTV, Cameron Williams.
And I'm Amelia Bruni. Thanks for watching and happy Valentine's.
Another show comes to an end. Thanks for watching today, and we hope you enjoy the 3-day weekend. Watch the Super Bowl on Sunday, and then take the next day to relax and rest. For everyone here at VTV, I'm Summer Owens. Have a great day.